It is a matter of great honor that we are starting a postgraduate diploma in Manuscriptology and Palaeography here at the Regional Center of Bangalore. We have done that last year at the Delhi Center and the response was fantastic. And why we started this course has a brief history. 2 years back, I was invited for a valedictory function of a teacher's training program of history who belonged to different colleges in India. So there were more than 200 teachers of history who were either assistant professors or associate professors. And when I spoke to them about subjects like iconography, paleography, manuscriptology, they were all blank. They did not have any clue what to do with these subjects. And when I finished my lecture, they all came and said, "We think as if we have not done anything in our life because we have not come across these subjects. We are not aware of these subjects and we are only teaching the routine things as a part of history in our country." Students of manuscriptology and paleography must be knowing that India has the richest treasure of manuscripts in the entire world. In fact, a rough estimate says that we have more than 20 million manuscripts in India, which is double than the size of the manuscripts available in the entire world. And that is only the known resources. We are not asking about the unknown resources. Like, unknown means I may be having some manuscripts, some ancestral manuscripts in my house. Muru Swamiji might be having some manuscripts in their house. Banuji must be having. So these are all unknown resources. So you can imagine how much treasure of history we have within our own country. But the unfortunate part is that we are not vigilant to read all those manuscripts. Unfortunately, we don't have people who can decipher these rare scripts. Last year, we organized a workshop here on Modi and Tiglari Lipi, and it was very well received. And you would wonder that the participants' age group varied from 28 to 75. People are so interested to read those manuscripts, but unfortunately, we are not in a position to train our manpower in that area. So last year we thought that why don't we start a specialized course in manuscriptology and paleography. At Delhi, it was very well received. Another important subject is iconography, about which many people do not know. And we don't have many experts who can decipher the iconographic notations which are available in our sculptures, our heritage monuments. So those are supposed to be read. And unless we read, who is going to tell us about our heritage, rich cultural heritage? We often say that we have rich cultural heritage, but nobody knows about that rich cultural heritage. So that is why this prompted us to start this course. We are happy that the University of Bangalore has been kind enough to extend the support to us. They have also acknowledged us as the Center of Excellence. And that is how this course has picked up. I am told that 10 students have already taken admission, but I am sure that in next couple of days, the number of students would be more than that. And that is very important. Yesterday, another interesting thing happened. Dipti was a spectator to that event, and that was also an important event which prompted me to share with this incidence with you. Yesterday, I was asked to inaugurate a workshop of students who came from United States of America, 30 of them, and all of them belonging to the age group of 16 to 18. They are in the pre-college days and they have already learned 2 years of Sanskrit there, and this is the third year they are reading Sanskrit in United States of America. You can imagine that somebody residing in United States of America is interested to study Sanskrit other than their regular studies, so that they are in a position to know about our ancient cultural heritage. Unfortunately, in our own country, in our own domain, we are negligent to read, we are negligent to learn Sanskrit as a part of our regular studies. So if this continues, then I think after few years, we will not be even worthy of telling that we have rich cultural heritage, because we have not done anything to preserve, conserve, or even know about our rich cultural heritage. So students who have taken admission in this course not only have a large academic responsibility of completing this course, but they also have a very big cultural and social responsibility to take it further, so that more and more people get interested to learn and to know about these subjects in coming days. You become our brand ambassadors. In the state of Karnataka itself, you have rich treasures of manuscripts available in Modi and Tiglari Lipi and other lipis. We have rich cultural heritage written in Sharda and Nevari and Prakrit and Pali lipis. But unless we have bright young scholars coming forward and learning those scripts to decipher these manuscripts, everything is waste. I cite an example of Mongolia when it was invaded. They had rich treasures of manuscripts. All of them have gone. They were burnt or they were destroyed. Mongolia may be a big country, but they do not have resource to preserve or retrieve those manuscripts. So despite having a rich treasure of manuscripts, today they do not have anything with them. There are natural calamities by which our manuscripts get destroyed. I had been to Srinagar and I came to know that because of flood, rich treasure of manuscripts, which were Persian and Sanskrit manuscripts, they were destroyed because of the flood. Things are going away out of our hand. This is very important juncture. We have to take care of our treasure. So I know that it becomes a little serious for these small kids. Had I been fluent in Kannada, I would have told them also, but since you are fluent in Kannada, please explain these kids also that what is the importance of this subject, so that when they come to their college level, they also get interested to follow this kind of courses whenever they are having an option to choose their path of future career. So this is a serious issue. We have to address this issue on a more serious note, on a more sincere note. We all know that terracotta is a popular tradition throughout the country. In almost 16 states, different idols of terracotta are made. I was in Chhattisgarh. Terracotta is very popular art form there in Chhattisgarh. It is very popular in Jharkhand. It is very popular in even Maharashtra. But this is the beauty of our Indian culture tradition, that each terracotta idol or each terracotta sculpture belonging to different states has a different significance and connotation, and you can easily make out from which state this terracotta idol belongs to. That is the variety of our Indian cultural tradition. And this is the prayer of God. We are happy that an eminent artist like Muru Swamiji, along with his artist and team, has devoted time to make these sculptures here possible. I am keen that he should come to Delhi and do something for our Delhi office also. When I joined the Delhi office, we did not have terracotta idol at the front gate, but I wanted elephants on the front gate. And people say that according to Vastu Shastra, you should have elephants on your entry gate. Am I right? Yeah. We had horses on our entry gate. So everything was running away out of our hands. So we thought we'll have elephants on our gate. So I also requested Deepti ji to kindly help us out in getting these elephants made at the IGNCA main gate. So she said she wants 2 quintal of red mud there. So I said, I got frightened. I said, I mean, I can bring you money, but I can't bring 2 quintal of red mud. So anyway, as I said, that we have different terracotta traditions in other parts of the country. We could got it made. And now we have 2 huge elephants welcoming you at the gates of IGNCA also. So whenever you come, you will see those elephants welcoming you at the IGNCA. And let us hope that good luck comes back to IGNCA now. These are important, these are auspicious, they have their own mythological importance. They are not only the sculptures made out of mud, made out of our sand or something like that. And when an artist makes them with their involvement like a soul, it becomes their own child. It is not only an idol which is made out of some artistry, but they are also their own child. It is their own creation. So when you look at them, you should also look with the perspective that this has been created by a person putting his mind, body and soul, spending his time and energy, and also extending his or her creativity to that creation. And when you look at them with this perception, I think your entire beauty and entire joy changes. I'm happy that it happened at Bangalore. Whether God had been kind enough to at least give us some respite of inaugurating them today, it's not raining today, and these are the monuments which would be seen by many people in years to come. Again, I'll say that these kids should be trained in this kind of art. You have been doing that. We have a Kinhal art workshop, because these kids have stopped playing with mud these days. I don't know. Abhi, you play with mobile or you play with mud? Mud? Good, very good. So you should play with mud. You should play with your own indigenous things rather than playing with mobile. These days, people play football on mobile. They play cricket on mobile. Okay? So rather than playing it on the mobile phone, you should play it on the ground. That increases the joy of your life. That will give you more joy. Mobile is a dead medium. You are playing with yourself. So you don't have any competition, you know. Even if you are, say, playing that once the end game, hai na? You play end game, some accident, somebody comes, fire, and all this. But then after a couple of days, you understand what is going to happen next. So then you are playing with yourself. So that stops your creativity. When you play with the mud, with the things like that, your creativity gets increased. So I also request Deepthi to do regular workshops with these kids. Naseem ji is there. She also conducts workshops for kids. This is the golden opportunity for the kids to learn a lot and be greater citizens of this country.